Welcome back. In this segment, we see how Bursa Malaysia and the Malaysian currency performed. Only 3 days of trading, the market was closed for the Taipusam festivities and the City Day celebrations. For that, we have in the studio Izrul Zainal Abidin, analyst with the Malaysian Association of Technical Analysts, MATA. Welcome to the studio, Izrul.
Thank you for having me again.
Good to see you again. Okay, questions for you on Bursa. How did Bursa close today and close the week?
Index closes higher this week compared to last week. Okay. Today, FBM KLCI closed at 1870, okay, up by 1.08%. However, the volume is very low this week, okay, due to long holiday on Wednesday and Thursday.
Understandably.
And continue holiday today. Luckily, you are here today, Mike. and volume recorded for this week is only 6.25 billion, okay, compared to last week, which is 18 billion. Yeah. And 3 weeks ago, the highest was 27 billion shares traded.
So it's a bit difficult to compare 3 days and 5 days, yes, of our volume. But anyway, what are the factors that pushed out the market this week?
Okay. For this week, we have seen the top gainers, Bursa itself.
Yeah.
So those who are not really familiar, Bursa actually also is a traded counter.
Yeah.
So Bursa was raised by 2.62% this week.
Okay.
And CIMB goes up by 4.10%. Or the first 2 days of trading this week, but closes lower today at 1.27.
I see.
Mostly on the finance sector is moving up the counters.
Is that nothing to, something to do with the OPR hike last week and made banking stocks a little bit more attractive?
Yes, definitely. Yeah. It's very interesting when talking about OPR. For example, CIMB. CIMB is the first bank announcing the BLR hike on 26 January last week. But the rate will effective starting from today.
Mm-hmm.
And the OPR, some people say that OPR will somehow reflect the market. But from my studies, it shows that by risk 3.25 basis point, previously the index was hovering around 1860 and later it drops to 1640. Later only the OPR was adjusted.
Yeah.
Basically, what I'm trying to say is that actually the stock market is the leading indicator to the OPR, not the other way around.
Hey, Izrul, you're talking about banking stocks and raising their interest rates and all that. From my experience over the past 30 over years, I always notice about banks, when they raise the rate, they do it immediately, you know.
Yeah.
When they lower down the rate, they'll take a long time to do that.
Definitely.
I've talked to some bankers I know, you know. So, Malaysian shares, I think, rose to more than a three-year high on Monday. I think KLCI climbed 0.9% to 1870.52. Mm-hmm. What pushed the market on Monday?
Okay, basically on Monday, even though the volume is quite high, but from the statistic, it shows that basically the foreign funds actually is taking profit during that time.
Okay.
And our institution coming in and buy over.
I see. Okay, for today, I understand that the market was slightly lower in sentiment, but oil and gas stocks performed commendably well, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So why so, Izrul?
Basically because of the oil price itself. And oil is traded around $69 per barrel.
Okay.
It continued to strengthen due to strong fuel demand,
okay,
output cuts by OPEC and collapsing Venezuelan product.
Okay.
Oil futures immediately raised by 0.8% and Goldman Sachs 6 month price expectation to be at $82 per barrel.
Yeah. The other thing is that I understand foreign net buying continued for the ninth consecutive week. Is it the question which kept the composite index at a high level? So is this trend expected to continue into next week and in the first quarter?
Mm-hmm. Like I said just now, earlier this week, the foreign fund starting to taking profit, and our institution started to coming in. What is very interesting for next week, because even though the very low volume this week, but the stock price is going up, the FBM KLCI is going up.
Okay.
This we should trade very cautiously next week,
okay,
because of three reasons. The first, this week raise because of low volume is not a healthy move.
Okay.
The second one, on technically, price has reached the upper Bollinger Band.
Okay.
And the third one, it's already traded above a very thin line, Ichimoku cloud.
Okay, what is your projection for next week for the KLCI?
Next week, I'm expecting we'll have a short pullback.
Mm-hmm.
And probably later next week or earlier the following week, then only we are starting on the Chinese New Year rally.
So
that's a very interesting in Malaysia.
Okay, and topics for the next sector next week, as far as sectors are concerned, not the counters.
Okay. For the sectors, I'm still looking at banking sectors.
Okay.
Because somehow it still reflects on the OPR.
Okay. And okay, let's go to the ringgit. How did the ringgit perform this week?
Okay,
Was it able to extend last year's gains, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The ringgit closed higher against the US dollar today.
Yeah.
On improved sentiment after the US Federal Reserve keep its interest rate unchanged.
Okay.
So today it closed at 3.88.
Okay. And then to what extent will the OPR support? Because you said the OPR supported the banking stocks. Mm-hmm. To what extent will the OPR support the ringgit, you know?
Okay.
How long maybe, you know, maybe can we see 3.80 in the near term, you know?
Definitely. A few weeks ago, I mentioned that we're going to reach 3.85 very soon. And now we're already 3.88, not even first quarter.
Okay.
So probably 3.80 is achievable within this first half.
First half of this year. So I hope you're wrong, you know, because I hope they achieve it in the first quarter, you know.
Okay. Very soon.
So there are some predictions say the ringgit will hover around 3.80 even earlier,
mm-hmm.
Because of the elections and mm-hmm. Foreign funds coming in and all that. Do you subscribe to this notion that the ringgit will even accelerate further, you know, rather mm-hmm. than predictions and all that? Because remember I told you one bank predicted that the ringgit will go to 3.8 at the end of this year.
Yeah.
The end of last year it went to 3.8. So now we're at 3.88, is it?
All right. So next time don't ask the bank. Come and ask me.
Okay. See?
So basically... even though the momentum is there, but definitely there will be some pullback because the ringgit has been strengthening from week to week for about 6 weeks now.
Okay. So for this week it is a 3-day holiday shortened week and all that.
Mm-hmm.
For next week, will the stock market accelerate further? Will the ringgit be higher next week?
You know? Okay. For the stock market, I anticipate that the stock will be a bit slow next week because of due to the long holiday this week and the slow momentum and also a negative sentiment on the global equities this week.
Okay.
So the Dow Jones is having a minor retracement.
Okay.
And the Nikkei 225 also having a pullback, and also European stocks also having a little bit pullback.
What about other regional markets? How are they doing?
Compared to this regional market, except for Singapore, the rest also is having a pullback.
So, when you look at it at a macro point of view, is Bursa Malaysia still an attractive market for foreign fund managers?
Yes, definitely. Because of so many sentiments around.
Like what?
Basically, in Malaysia, like I mentioned just now, it's a Chinese New Year rally is coming. And the biggest one is the election rally is coming. And also the strengthening of the ringgit. And also the strengthening of the oil price.
So you're talking like a combination of many factors.
Yes.
So are you trying to say it's a good time to buy now? Monday morning you're going to stand outside the bursa to start buying?
Yes, it's good time now because you can get a bottom fishing for next week.
Okay, what would be the catalyst for the ringgit strength next week? Will there be more players in the market for the ringgit?
For the ringgit, still goes for the oil price.
Okay.
And the strengthening, the weakening of the greenback itself.
Okay.
So we need to be cautious. Like I mentioned just now, ringgit probably will have a little bit pullback mm-hmm. for a moment before continue strengthening to 3.80.
Israel, there's also one more thing that besides all these factors you talked about, there's also talk that the Malaysian economy is doing quite well. You know, so maybe the first quarter economic growth will also help to prop up the market and the currency.
Based on REM ratings, their projection for this year economic growth 5.2%.
Okay.
So it's very good. Comparing to a previous year.
For the whole year, right?
For the whole year, yeah.
Okay. What about for the first quarter and maybe the second quarter?
For the first quarter, we can see that they will meet up the quarter-to-quarter benchmark.
Okay.
Probably 2% by this first quarter is achievable because of very strong momentum right now.
Because you mentioned about the Chinese New Year rally, you know, and the Chinese New Year is only about less than 2 weeks away. Are you talking about Monday?
Probably end of next week.
Probably the end of next week. Okay, I'll hold you to that. What you said.
Sure.
So I'm going to buy some stocks on Monday. You know?
Yeah.
And there'll be a rally in the ringgit also?
Ringgit will be softening a little bit.
Okay.
Because now, even this week, ringgit is mixed. Performance compared to regional currencies.
So you always bring good news for the market. So thank you, Israel, for those pointers on the market. Hope to have you back on the show soon.
Okay. Sure.
That's all the time we have for BizTalk today. And thank you, Mary Fair, for that gorgeous set. Until the next time, bye for now.